Thank you. Warm afternoon to everybody, specifically Prakash Garu, Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, Reddy Sir, Mr. Bijan Mishra, and the audience. Thank you for being here with us today. It is a relief to have a live conference after a very, very long time. We've held many webinars, etc., and it's a relief to be in a hall and, of course, ensure that we're wearing our masks, etc. Speaking after Chetan is not an easy task because he covers everything. In a way, it's easy for us to just to, you know, touch upon and skim the surface. So thanks again, Chetan, for the wonderful presentation. Just a couple of points that he made, I'll just like to reiterate. You know, India has a long way to go. If you saw his slide on the global statistics on how different countries are doing, with a very sizable population, young population, a strong consumer base, we are barely $3 billion compared to $30 billion plus in China and US and other countries. So I think a lot of work for everyone here and a lot of potential for us. The second interesting thing, as I did see a lot of the audience smile when the gender slides came across, you know, globally 70% women, and I'm glad seeing a lot of women in the audiences here today. But in the Indian context, yes, please, give yourselves a hand. Yes, please. But in the Indian context, obviously, Jayesh, this is something very key for us all, Prakash Garu as well, that obviously in the Indian context, direct selling is more than just part-time kind of an opportunity. I think in the Indian context, obviously, men are seeing this as a employment and income generating activity. So that's an interesting point to note. And from the industry perspective, what I can share with the direct sellers in Telangana, as well as Jayesh sir and Prakash Garu, Bijan sir and Mr. Reddy, is that during the COVID time, most direct selling companies, at least the IDSA companies, have telescoped our operations very much, sir. What we had planned, let's say, over the next 5 years in terms of digital, in terms of minimizing the direct sellers' movement, in terms of coming into offices to collect their products, that was telescoped into 5 months of hard work. So, of course, COVID has been a terrible time for most of us, for all of us, in fact. But as an industry, we've had to adapt very fast, and I think the Indian Direct Selling Association member companies have done so admirably. Specific to Telangana, I think the Telangana government, absolutely, I would certainly thank two fine gentlemen sitting here, Prakash Garu and Jayesh sir, have always been tremendous supporters of this industry, and kindly give them a round of applause for that. The Telangana government has, as Chetan pointed out, was probably the third state to notify the guidelines in 2017 or thereabouts. Jayesh sir has always been very, very supportive for all kind of meetings, whether we wanted to clarify the way forward, etc. And his support, Prakash sir's support as well, has been very, very strong. So from our side, a great round of thanks to the Telangana government for such clarity. I'll be amiss if I didn't recognize Bijan sir's contribution to this industry as well. He's been a spokesperson for us. He's understood the industry, the strengths, the consumer connect, and I'm sure when he speaks, he'll be able to talk about the consumer connect from his perspective very, very strongly. And finally, as Chetan did point out, the center is working on rules for this industry under the Consumer Protection Act. We've been working very closely, IDSA as an association, been working very closely with various central ministries over the last, I would say, 5-6 years. I think the guidelines in 2017 were just the first stepping stone as such. And the rules, well, we are quite hopeful that in this year we should see the rules. There will be a mechanism for registration, sir, for direct selling entities. And I suspect we'll come back to you at that time for further support, because that holds the key. Because once there's a strict filtration system for which are clear direct selling business models, then there will be minimal confusion out there in the market. So thank you all very much for your patience, and good luck to us all. Thank you so much.